Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG. This is another video from the know-how series for engineers, it must know for you guys. And in today's video, we're going to bring the DXF file. We're going to bring a few houses here. You're going to have a look how to do it. We're obviously going to use a AutoCAD drawing from where we're going to take any information, and we're going to bring it into the instrument. So let's go. That's from my job here. I landed for the 1 week job there, so that's going to be perfect just to show you how to do it. And that's the real life, obviously. That's what I was doing there, so that will be the best for you to have a look as well. So I got this cut drawing of all these houses here, but what I'm going to need now, guys, to set out for me, for myself, as this is already built here, I'm going to need 461, 462 and 463, and that's only this what I'm going to bring here. I'm just going to show you from I got this information. This is the foundation layout here, so that's the blocks here, 463, 462 and 461. That's the garage here, you can see it. We got the levels here, and I got a setting out information here as well on the PDF, and the designer giving us the information about the corners of each house, so it's very good information. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, and on this drawing here we got all this information. So 461, point number 1, 2, 3 and 4. So we could actually go obviously old school and just type in the coordinates, which is all right as well, but this video is about DXF, and I want to show you how to prepare the DXF drawing and how we're going to use it. So guys, I got the AutoCAD, and before I bring this, I want to make sure this is coordinated drawing. I know that it is, but what I always do, I actually want to make sure the information is exactly the same as the one on the PDF, on the drawing, which we should actually use. So I'm going to do the point here. You cannot really see this point, so in this case we're going to go here, point style, and we're going to change the point style to here. 5% is quite okay, so that's our point now. And I'm going to click it here, and I'm going to see the coordinates. I'm going to go jump back quickly to our PDF drawing. Was 461, and I believe that was point number 1. 461 point number 1 is this one here. So we got 33431, 33431, 66944, 66944. That's perfect. So that's exactly the same point. So probably designer just using this drawing just to give us the information on the PDF. But whatever it is, we just double check the corner of this house here. So that's going to be opposite corner. I'll just quickly jump here, and I'm going to press this point. I want to make sure. Just go back quickly to the setting now. That was house number 463 and point number 1 as well. So 463, point number 1 is this one here. So you get 29588, 31889. Perfect, guys. And I just doing this. Obviously, once you're sure you're drawing this coordinated, you don't have to do it. But I always prefer to do as much steps as I can just to make sure I know what I'm doing. And this gives me the confidence, and I don't have to think again if this is for sure or if this was all right. I know this is right from the very start, and it takes you half a minute maybe, and you know the drawing is coordinated 100%. So what I'm going to do, guys, now, obviously I'm not going to be bringing all this drawing in, as I'm bringing only the information I need. And as I said, I need only these four houses, and I'm going to bring the information about only these four houses. And actually what I need, you see the points here, I need only this outside line to do my setting out. And I'm going to prepare it now. I'm just going to bring these four houses here. And another reason why I'm bringing it on the other drawing is, look how many layers are here. So there's no point bringing this, and that will be actually maybe even impossible to bring it into the EDM. So what I'm going to do now, I'm actually changing for the one layer, maybe doesn't really matter. I just press this one, and I still got them marked here. And what I'm going to do now, I press Ctrl+Shift+C. This is copy with a base point, and I'm going to copy this with a 0, 0 base point. And I'm going to press Enter now. And we're going to use this option with bringing the DXF information from the EDM onto the drawings while we're going to be doing as-builds as well. But for this, we're going to open a new drawing now. AutoCAD light, that's okay, it doesn't really matter. What I'm going to do now, I'm going to press Ctrl+V, and I'm going to bring it with this very same point, obviously, base point 0, 0, and that's going to get my houses in the same position as the original one. I just double click here, and I got my houses here, and that's the information I'm going to bring into the EDM. But before I do it, guys, I actually gonna mark all of it, and I'm gonna explode it using the explode option. This is explode now, and I'm gonna get rid of whatever I don't need here, so I can delete it. I can actually mark it, or maybe select similar as you can see, it is selected now, and I'm going to delete it, and I'm going to get rid of all information I don't need. As I only need the outside lines, I'm going to delete all of this. I don't really need this, as I said. All these arrows, we can actually mark it, select similar, and we can delete it too. We're going to bring only the information we need to set out the lines, the foundation, and whatever we need really. So I just, and that's the information I'm looking for, guys. Four houses here, I actually need them three, but I'm going to save it now. I'm going to put Control Shift save. I'm going to save it drawing four. So I'm going to save it as, put the name houses, and I'm going to bring it straight into our US memory stick. As I said, to the data job, as the EDM gonna find it here in this data folder. And obviously, important thing here, guys, is saving it as a DXF file, and we're gonna bring the DXF file. So I'm gonna save it as a 2010 DXF file, called it houses, so houses.dxf, and I'm gonna save it. We're gonna bring it into the instrument in a minute. So guys, it's saved as houses now. I just realized we got this, all these houses as a blocks now. So what I'm gonna do now, I just mark all of them, and I'm going to explode it again to have my lines separate. So now you can see all these lines are separate now, and I'm just going to save it now before I bring it into our instrument. So I got my EDM here now. I'll make it a little bit bigger maybe for you guys. Yeah, it's a little bit better now. So what I'm going to do now, guys, we're going to go jobs and data as before, and we're going to import data. And in this time, going to be number two, import DXF data. So I'm going to go DXF here, internal memory. Now we're bringing this from the USB stick. And I'm going to press here. You can see the DXF file is found already in the data USB. So, but we're not going to bring it into the control. We actually open a new job here. We're going to call it houses as well. No description. We're going to store it. Okay. I'm going to bring them into the job houses. Just to show you quickly here, configure, the configuration here. We got block, prefix, point, and the line, and the file units. And this is important, guys. As you could see, the coordinates I have for the corners of the buildings, and all the drawings was coordinated in meters. So the information we have in meters, and that's how we're going to keep it. But once your drawing going to be in millimeters, and you need to keep an eye on this as well, as sometimes I see people trying to bring the millimeter drawing using here file units as a meters. So that's completely wrong information. You cannot do any setting out later then. So yeah, that's what we have. We got meters here. And as I said, once you got millimeters, you need to change here for millimeters. And your drawing going to be brought here into millimeters. And you're going to be actually working with your EDM with the meters anyway. But you need to tell your EDM how to bring it here. But we got meters, as I said. We're going to press OK. OK. The job is brought here. It's 71 lines important. I don't know why so many, but we're going to have a look now. So guys, the job is now set at the house's job. And what I usually do, I just actually work from the map later once I got the drawing brought as a DXF. So I'm going to go map here. We're going to press here to find our houses. And we got them here. And look, the information here, actually, it brought me too many lines. I was surprised why so many lines. And there was some extra lines brought in here. So that's actually show you what's going to happen once you're going to bring too much information. It's all going to be confusing, and it's not going to be not easy to work. The reason for it, actually, in this case, I think there was some layers frozen, and once I thought I cleared the drawing completely, it still brought me some extra lines. So you can see always something can happen. So that's why you want to open this, double check once you brought it into the controller, and you can actually clear it again here. You can press this not needed lines, tap and hold, and you can delete the objects in the instrument itself, so there's no problem with it. And as I did, I exploded the drawings to have a line separate. You can see line 84, 85. So once we're going to click the line now, once we do our resection and we are ready to go, we connect it with our prism here, we just tap the line, press and hold, and we can use it in the reference line. We can stake the line, we can do some offsets, so we can go OK. And obviously, once we connect it, we're going to press distance, and we're going to start doing setting out, which you can see actually on my setting out videos. So yeah, guys, that will be all in today's video. We just brought the DXF drawing. And as I said, that's a very good example now, because that was actually from the job I was doing here for a week. we got these houses here built, some foundation was already done, and I was setting few foundations here as well. So yeah, guys, if you like this video, please leave the thumbs up, just leave some comments. If you got any questions, leave this in the comment sections as well, and I'm going to reply as soon as possible. And yeah, thank you again for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and see you next time.